All right. Everything that we have spoken since evening today, we will demonstrate that to all of you today, including charging the food, how to charge the food, okay? And Sister Shivani has given one way, which is a 20-second prayer intention that you send to the food. We also have amongst us Dr. Chandrashekhar Tiwari, who has invented a, not invented, but Dr. Chandrashekhar, wait, we will call you. I'm just creating the excitement so the energy remains in the room. We are at the fag end of the program right now. So Dr. Chandrashekhar will demonstrate to you how to charge your food with a small instrument that we'll talk about it. The food that we're going to serve today, it has been a very great attempt to make it as close to as what we have been talking since evening today. And we'll introduce the person who curated the food today to us. She's amongst all of us today. She's going to be here. But before that, we have a very, very, interesting subject. I heard it for the first time. What a pleasure and what a blessing for us to have Dr. Sunil Kumar Joshi, who's come all the way just for this event from Haridwar, and he's an expert on Marma therapy, right? I'm not sure how many of you have heard of Marma therapy. My apologies, Marma therapy, all right? Not many. So Dr. Joshi, you have a big opportunity to educate all of us together. All right, yes, I'll give you the clicker. That's the one to go forward.
Namaskar, everyone. First of all, I thank Mr. Tony Singhji. It is my privilege to come here to share my views regarding the Marma therapy. मैं दोनों तरफ से बोलूँगा, हिंदी इंग्लिश में बोलूँगा क्योंकि because we have to understand. क्योंकि उसको मर्म को समझने के लिए मर्मा, just we have not to say Marma therapy. It is Marma means it is the vitality and the essence of the thing. जैसे हम लोग कहते हैं कि it is Marma घात. And just you have not gone through the essence of the topic. इस विषय के मर्म को आप नहीं समझे. In same way, just it is the Vedic way of physical, mental and the spiritual health improvement. And just we can say that Marma science and Marma therapy is the system of curing the disease through the 107 vital points situated in the human body. First of all, we have to know the efficacy of these Marma points, importance of these Marma points. Just you can, you have heard about the demise of Lord Krishna. There was arrow on the soul of Lord Krishna, and there is a point, it is known as the Tal Hirdaya Marma. It is written in the text that there are five hearts in the human body, four on the soul and the palm, and one in the thorax. So with the help of these Marma points, just we can regulate the function of the brain and heart. So it is a common practice when the person is unconscious. We used to rub the soul and palm. Just I have asked many people why we are doing this practice. They used to say that just we have to increase the blood circulation. But it is not the matter of blood circulation because the medical person know that there is a fat, pad of fat is there, and if you want to increase the blood circulation, you have to rub the more area of the human body. Because there is a point located over here, it is known as the Tal Hirdaya Marma, and it is very important to treat the diseases of the brain and the heart. For the hypertension, you can cure the hypertension with the help of this Marma, and how to identify, because it is this session is dedicated to the nutrition, and I am talking about the entirely different subject. So just it is a glimpse. I am giving some glimpses about the Marma science and Marma therapy. When you are closing your hand like this, where the middle finger touches, it is the Tal Hirdaya Marma. So it is very important point for the management of the blood pressure as well as the epilepsy and the seizure disorders. It is just we are using this point for the pre-emergency management. If the patient comes to our clinic with the hypertension 220/110 mm of Hg. So in this condition, we don't have the sublingual lifidapine or intravenous, any injection, diuretic or compose like medicine. So instantly just we are going to press this point and within couple of seconds, it drops 30 mm of Hg. So kitna jaldi ye theek kiya ja sakta hai, to just we are using this point as a medical just management of the hypertension. Just I am limiting myself for few Marma points because it is very interesting to know that if we have to change the whole scenario of the medical science, just we have to teach and train the people for the Marma science and Marma therapy because it is the Vedic way of healing and it came from the Anganyas and the Karanyas. Whenever we are doing any procedure, any koi bhi karma kand hum karte hain, yagya karte hain, havan karte hain, just we are touching some body points. And these body points are related with these Marma points and all the chakras are also similar to these Marma points. There is a point located over here, it is known as the Adhipati Marma. It is means the master point. It is just located over the jahan pe hamari choti rakhi rehti hai, wahan pe hota hai. It is just by putting the pressure of all five fingers together over this point, it improves our vitality. So just like mobile, there is a port opening. The same port size is over here, and it is said that when prana enters in the body through this point, and also it goes away from this body. आपने देखा होगा जब भी कोई व्यक्ति मरता है तो कपाल क्रिया के रूप में इसी जगह पे लकड़ी से उसको छुआ जाता है. तो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट इज नोन एज द मास्टर पॉइंट. सो ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. जस्ट आई एम कीपिंग माई सेल्फ लिमिटेड टू द डिजीजेस ऑफ द न्यूट्रिशन और द फूड और द डाइट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू पॉइंट्स. जस्ट आई हैव डिस्कस्ड वन पॉइंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ जस्ट यू कैन ट्रीट द इंसोम्निया एज वेल एज मेमोरी एंड इंटेलेक्ट वट एवर इट इज रिलेटेड विद द ब्रेन एंड हार्ट. यू कैन regulate the by the remote sensing technique of this Marma. Second point is because the each and every part of the body is measured in the fingers. Pure sharir ki lambai hamari 120 angul hoti hai. Isko kehte hai apad mastak. Apad mastak means tip to bottom. Aise yadi hum pair ko rakhenge to then it will be 120 fingers. 84 fingers the whole body and 46 finger. यहाँ से यहाँ तक की दूरी 16 अंगुल होती है. यहाँ से यहाँ तक की दूरी 6 अंगुल होती है. 4 10 26 अंगुल यहाँ तक की होती है. यदि आप देखें 84 पॉइंट प्लस 26 इट मीन्स 110. एंड वेन एवर वी आर रेजिंग अवर लेग्स लाइक दिस 10 फिंगर्स. सो टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द बॉडी इज 120 एंड ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी इज मेजर्ड इन द फिंगर्स. वेन यू आर पुटिंग योर थंब ओवर हियर दिस पार्ट इज नोन अप टू दिस पार्ट. It is G-fi sternum to this notch. It is one from this region to this umbilicus one, and from umbilicus to symphysis pubis, it is one. This part is related with the pranavayu. The middle part is related with the samanavayu, and inferior part is related with the apanavayu. The middle part is related with the digestion and the nutrition. So how we can deal with the problems related with the GIT, we have to press the one point that is known as the Kurparman. Kaise naapte hain isko? And it is very good for the diabetes as well as for the obesity. With the help of stimulating this Marma point, you can decrease your weight up to 25 to 30 kg in 4 to 5 months without using any medicine. Sirf aapko uski janna hai ki kaise usko karte hain. और कैसे करते हैं उसको? जस्ट यू कैन पुट योर थंब ओवर द ऑलिक्रेनियन प्रोसेस. ऐसे डालिए बीच की उंगली जहां पे आती है. इट इज द आउटर पार्ट ऑफ दिस मर्मा एंड इट इज वेरी यहां पे अंगूठा रख लीजिए ऐसे इस प्रेसेस पे ये इंडेक्स फिंगर डालिए और बीच की उंगली जहां पे आती है उसको हम लोग कहते हैं कुरपर एंड द सिमिलर पार्ट फ्रॉम दिस साइड. If the person is suffering with the hiccough, kisi ko hichki aa rahi hai and you are not able to treat the hiccough, once again. You have to put the thumb over here. Ye isko hum log olecranon process kehte hain. Haddi ke upar ye angutha rakhi. Place your index finger over the creases. Second middle finger. The outer part of the elbow. And parallel to this point, these two parts are known as the purparman. And it is very important for the diabetes. Diabetes ko aap theek kar sakte ho without any medication, and the person is suffering with the severe pain in the abdomen without any surgical lesion. If there is any pain in the abdomen and there is no surgical lesion, you can treat the pain abdomen without any medication. You have to press it 15 to 18 times in one sitting and 3 sittings in a day. And the average stimulus should not more than 0.8 second. दशमलव 8 सेकंड से ज्यादा एक कार्डियक साइकिल से ज्यादा का स्टिमुलस नहीं होना चाहिए. यू हैव नॉट टू प्रेस लाइक एक्यूप्रेशर और द एक्यूपंचर. यू हैव टू गिव द स्टिमुलस एंड अगेन यू हैव टू रिलीज इट. इसकी दूसरी एक टेक्निक और बता देते हैं कि वेन एवर यू आर रिसाइटिंग ओम नमः शिवाय, तो 72 बार यदि ओम नमः शिवाय कहते हैं तो इट टेक्स ओनली 60 सेकेंड्स. तो एक मिनट में 60 बार होता तो यू कैन गिव द 0.8 सेकेंड स्टिमुलस. दबाइए छोड़िए, दबाइए छोड़िए, दबाइए छोड़िए छोड़िए, और 15 से 20 बार एक बार को कीजिए. और उससे क्या होगा, उससे आप डायबिटीज को ठीक कर सकते हो. कैसे ठीक कर सकते हैं, एंड अनदर एक्सरसाइज इज देयर, इट इज नोन एज द मर्म प्राणासन. सो यू हैव टू कीप योर हैंड इन दिस वे. देखिए ये सारी चीजें बताई नहीं जा सकती, लेकिन सिर्फ GIT से संबंधित बातें मैं इसलिए बता देना चाहता हूं कि दिस सेशन इज रिलेटेड टू द न्यूट्रिशन. पुट योर हैंड लाइक दिस, कीप योर हैंड लाइक दिस. हाथों को यहां पे रखिए ऐसे, दाएं हाथ से बाएं हाथ को पकड़ेंगे, माता हैं जो है, बाएं हाथ से दाएं हाथ को पकड़ लें पुरुष, अगेंस्ट माता क्या करेंगे, दाएं हाथ से बाएं हाथ को पकड़ लिए, और हम लोग क्या करेंगे आपको जी, बाएं हाथ से दाएं हाथ को पकड़. देन यू हैव टू पुट योर हैंड इन दिस वे एंड जस्ट यू कैन फील द इंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ दिस बोन. फर्स्ट मेटाकार्पल विल टच द स्पेसिफिक पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी, इट इज नोन एज द स्तन मूल मर्म. यहां पे रखिए, एंड दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर ओवर हियर, इट इज नोन एज द आणि मर्म एंड द ऊर्वी मर्म, एंड यू आर पुटिंग योर हैंड लाइक दिस, एंड देन यू हैव टू टेक द डीप ब्रेथ, एंड व्हेन यू आर एक्सहेलिंग यू हैव टू गिव द प्रेशर ओवर हियर. व्हेनेवर यू आर गिविंग द प्रेशर टू दिस रीजन, अल्टीमेटली जस्ट यू आर गिविंग द डायरेक्ट स्टिमुलस टू द लिवर, गॉल ब्लैडर, पैंक्रियाज एंड द होल पार्ट, ट्रांसवर्स कोलन एंड द स्प्लीन. तो सारी की सारी एक्सरसाइज डायफ्राम के साथ साथ इसमें हो जाती है. साथ साथ क्या करना है, यू हैव टू कर दीजिए, व्हेन वी आर एक्सहेल यू हैव टू प्रेस दिस थिंग,
मैं पकड़ के आता हूं.
सो इट इज वेरी इफेक्टिव एक्सरसाइज फॉर ऑल GIT प्रॉब्लम्स एंड द ऑल मेटाबॉलिक डिसऑर्डर्स. जहां भी जितने भी ऑर्गन्स होते हैं वो सीधे ये एक्टिव एक्सरसाइज है. It is not a passive exercise. By any yogic procedures, you are giving the passive exercise to this region, but with the help of this marm pranasan, just you are giving direct stimulus to this region. कोई भी दुनिया में एक ऐसी exercise नहीं है जो सीधे इन organs को stimulate करती हो. तो so all organs related with the digestion and the metabolism of the food are located in this region. So liver, gallbladder, pancreas, duodenum, transverse colon, spleen and the stomach, all organs are coming within your own reach. And with the help of this stan mool marma, it is also stimulating this inferior part of the first metacarpal bone, is going to press this point. So with the help of this process you can stimulate the whole digestive process. Now the third point is located in this region, upper part, and it is good for the esophagus if there is any problem related with the deglutition or the hyperacidity. So in these two, with the help of these two parts, you can treat all these diseases related with the GIT. वैसे तो मर्म चिकित्सा को समझने में मुझे लगभग 30 वर्ष का समय लगा. तो इसको समझने के लिए निश्चित रूप से, बिकॉज इट इज ए सुपर साइंस एंड इट शुड बी इंप्लीमेंटेड इन ऑल ब्रांचेज ऑफ द मेडिकल साइंस, इट इज नॉन सर्जिकल नॉन मेडिसिनल ऑप्शन. सो जस्ट यू कैन सी द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ मर्म पॉइंट्स इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. देखते रहिए कि कैसे कैसे कर सकते हैं, व्हाट इज द स्कोप एंड लिमिटेशंस. जस्ट स्कोप, जस्ट यू वांट टू शो द स्कोप.
First of all, just you can treat a lot of cases related with the geriatric care, especially in case of osteoarthritis of the knee joint. About 5 lakh rupees are necessary for the replacement of one knee joint. So 10 lakh rupees ka kharcha ho gaya. Aur lagbhag 5 lakh knee replacement per annum hamare desh mein hote hain. Kitne hote hain? Aajkal har hamare Haridwar mein bhi hota hai, chote chote shaharon mein bhi hota hai. Only 2 minutes. So a lot of money is involved in this process. With the help of glufomerma stimulation, you can treat each and every case. So all these conditions, hemangioma, displacement of the umbilicus, bone contractures, post-operative sciatic nerve injury, non-healing ulcers, Down syndrome, autism, cerebral palsy, other delayed myelostone disorders, irritable bowel syndrome, lifestyle disorders, each and every disease can be cured by the Marma therapy. Thank you very much.
I know there's a lot of interest for what Dr. Joshi spoke, but if I just give you a couple of seconds to allow your excitement level to slow down and then ask you a question. How many of you would be interested to have a very detailed session on what Dr. Joshi just said, just by a show of hands? All right, fantastic. So, Tony, you have a micro event that we will communicate to all of you, and we'll invite Dr. Joshi according to his availability. But this is amazing, and I'm sure we have many more things to talk about it. As I said, one of the things I want to say, we are just winding up and we are moving. We're going to invite Meenu. But before Meenu is invited, Meenu was one of our speakers in one of our very early forums that we had. And she herself has been a type 2 diabetic, sufferer. And she got out of it from that day onwards. She became very passionate about it. But apart from everything else that she does, she is a healer, and she is also a very, very good cook on the plant-based cooking. She is the founder member of, she's the founder of the Padma Center in Hoskas in the Subdivision Development Area, and she supports anyone who wants to support for good work, for the humanity, for the environment. She's always very passionate to support it altogether. Before I invite Meenu to help you understand how the menu for dinner has been curated, I just want to take the permission from Sister Shivani to attempt one thing that I learned in one of the Gita sessions that I had a chance to attend by Pankaj Bansal. And in Bhagavad Gita and in Upanishad both, they say the food has to be treated with prayers before you eat. And there are two reasons. One is the bhog that you give to the food, jab bhog lagate hain, because you want to seek the blessing and the, all the energy from the Almighty. And the second is that the body is made of five elements, the way the whole environment is made, the whole Brahman is made of the five elements. And therefore, one of the things that we need to do is to give ahuti to the fire element in our stomach. Because the fire has to remain ignited all the time. And therefore, food is a way of giving ahuti. And therefore, all the emotions that Sister Shivani was talking about, it is very much documented in Bhagavad Gita. It is very much documented in Upanishad. Now you can read, or you can challenge, or you listen and do what we have just shared with you today. I mean, it's your choice. I mean, it's a matter of belief. We are not trying to attempt anything which is not documented with evidence. So emotions do play an important role. And I do remember when Sister Shivani was talking, one of the questions was coming that how can we stop children from eating out? How do we control the emotions with a maid? I think she gave some beautiful answers today. Minimize eating outside because emotion plays a role. Make sure that the maids are being taken care emotionally very well before they start cooking. So, you know, all of us, we need to start handling things a little bit more differently. But let's understand how the food has been curated, how we have made sure that the food that you're going to eat today is like an ahuti to the stomach. Let's put our hands together and invite Meenu Nageshwaran to help us understand the science and the emotions behind today's evening dinner. So, Meenu, please come.
You can change the slides from here. This one is to go forward. Thanks.
First of all, namaste to all of you. Some familiar faces, very fondly recognized familiar faces. How do I start? First of all, a disclaimer. The menu that was curated by me and that was intended for this evening, unfortunately, couldn't take off the ground because the cook, the head chef, actually, his wife has got cancer. So he's been in the hospital. So we've tried the best we can. Tony took over and curated the dinner finally. There are just four dishes actually, that I had intended for the evening. We have a moringa dal. Moringa, very high in nutrients, actually a superfood. It is a drumstick leaf, which is mega powerful. Everything about the tree is used, and it's a forgotten and ignored patta, which we've made a dal out of today. There are three salads. One is with micronutrients, with the microgreens. One with just cucumber and mint and pomegranate. And the third one is a sprout salad. All things high in prana. So, briefly, I'll just tell you that I had diabetes in 2012. Thanks to a program that I attended with Nanditasha, I reversed it in less than 2 months. And my counts were 454 and 633 postprandial. And thereafter, my journey began of understanding what I was doing, because I did think we ate healthy. I became a plant-based cook. I teach now, and I resonated a lot with what Sister Shivani was talking about today, about the energy of the food. And I've always believed in that, about prana, about what emotion we're putting into the food and what we're eating. And we all know we eat out a lot. So the big challenge to me now has become to be able to actually teach cooks and chefs. And I'm thrilled to share with you that just the day before yesterday, I was with 40 of the young chefs of India. They are the creme de la creme, so-called whiz chefs. And what we're trying to do is take them back. It's called the Young Chefs of Sustainable Food. So that is very close to my heart, because going along the way, I started offering a platform for people to be able to sell organic produce, and we do a market. I'm not changing the slides because I'll lose my strain of thought. The market has, people have been telling me, you know, it's different. There's a different energy. The food is delicious. Because we not just sell the produce, but we have people who cook there. Now, what is different about that food? It is because of the people who are making and growing that food. They are passionate, they are excited, they come from far distances to be there at the market 8:30 in the morning. And believe you me, it's a special, special space to be in on a Sunday morning. So I'm going to quickly go through the slides and see what I had intended to say. I had briefly wanted to talk about the three body cycles, which is what I follow today. The elimination period between 4 a.m. to 12 noon, the appropriation period between 12 p.m. to 8 p.m., and the assimilation period between 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. So essentially, if we dump our body with our first cup of tea in the morning, you are stopping your elimination cycle like this. And if you stay on easily digested foods like fruits or green juices, you have the hope of better health. These are the few tips which thankfully Daryl and Nandita have already gone through. We basically follow a plant-based, gluten-free, refined sugar-free, refined oil-free, and single grain and organic lifestyle. Single grain because in most homes we eat dal and chawal and roti together. It's not a good idea. It's a good idea to keep it as a single grain. And also The Indian thali is actually a beautiful representation of what we need to eat, with all the rasas, with all the tastes, and we've forgotten the art of doing that. So if we can stick to the sweet, the sour, the salty, the pungent, the bitter, and the astringent taste, we are in good hands. Vitamin P, I have to thank Dimpy a lot for this. I remember attending the opening of a hotel one evening, and it was 7 o'clock peak. I hadn't had early dinner those days, and they were serving snacks, and I kept asking, is this vegan, is this vegan, does it have cheese? Now, in a crowd of 1,000 people, that was really ridiculous. And then Dimpy told me, Meenu, are you hungry? I said, yes. She said, just eat. Well, I also know that while we talk about mindful eating, what we are actually doing is eating with a lot of fear. There are diets, there are fad diets, there's more information that we can, when we think of and assimilate in one go. But when we are eating with fear, what is the energy that we are consuming? And I re-looked at a video the other day by Anita Murjani. She's the lady who had the second life and cured her cancer miraculously and all of that. And the one thing that she said, that although she was a mindful eater, she bought right, she ate right, she did all those things, but the one defining factor that she had when she consumed everything and anything was fear. So I say today, let go of the fear, let go of these fad diets, and let's eat more at home. Now that culture of change to bring people back to eating at homes is going to take a while. So at the markets, what we also do is to bring back the forgotten foods. We cook with millets, we cook with sags, summer sags, which people don't even know. The chefs in the hotels are clueless. They look at the sags and say, what is this? They only know methi and palak, that's it. So 9 summer sags, we do free workshops. You know, so there's a lot of that we're doing which is beyond the market. It's a world that we are creating of connection, actually. We're in a world where we're on our cell phones and on our laptops all the time. We are creating a world where we're connecting, where people are interacting, where they're talking, where they're touching the food, where they're looking at the food, they're smelling something, things they've never done before. So, food, beware of gluttony, because we have actually come to a space where we have become gluttonous, where we start with this and then we end with the dessert and then we want to have the coffee and the tea also, and there's no end. But we never, food was not intended to be like that. You ate sattvic, sada khana, preferably, I mean, in the good old days on the floor. It was the correct position for digestion. All of that we've forgotten. And as we've talked about, most of us eat in front of the TVs these days. And rest. I know for a start, I don't do enough of that. Rest. The most critical part of well-being is doing nothing. And I think most of us have lost the art of doing that. We are looking at our phones, we are checking Gmail, Facebook, WhatsApp all the time. And the art of doing nothing is what I remember as a child. I could sit on the parapet of my home and I would gaze into nothingness. And my parents called me a daydreamer and they wondered what I was doing. But I remember that in my childhood memory, some of the most precious times I've had sitting all by myself doing nothing. So let's come back to that life and do it. So Meenu's Prana Kitchen, briefly, I'll tell you, we offer products, we offer workshops, we offer cooking classes and private catering. And the Earth Collective, my very special, special space. It's a space of connection. It's a space where we're doing actual farm to table. we're doing a conscious, so this, we use almost no plastic. We are very responsible about the way we conduct ourselves there, about how we clean up, how we come in, we come on time, we don't, we use biodegradable crockery and cutlery, all of that. And it's slow food at its best. It's the food that you've grown up eating and drinking. So even when you have a cup of chai, which they serve there with A2 milk, but that's another discussion. But one lady told the person who brought it there, she says, I have not had this gud wala chai in 70 years. So it is a very special space to be in. So we do all foods which are traditional, forgotten foods, cooking with lingura or arbika patta or things like that, which are no longer common anymore. Real food and regenerative farming. Most of our farmers are doing natural farming where nothing is touched. Nature reigns supreme. And as it was intended, that is the food that you're getting. So I'll end with a few photographs of the market. That's Raju from Laksh Farm making bajre ka roti. There's millets that we have in abundance. And fresh, fresh vegetables that you cannot dream of. I don't think the photographs are doing justice, so please come. Microgreens, some of which we're going to taste today, and I think Swati is here in the audience. There she is. She's brought in the microgreens today. And that's me talking to one of the young regulars at the market. That's all for now. Thank you so much. A lot of gratitude to all of you.
Thank you, Meenu. Thank you very much. One more time. Thank you. So if you want to buy organic vegetables, you can go to the Asian Games Village every Sunday. Some stuff here, you can pick up the leaflets and you know where to connect. One of the things which I discovered during the journey with TQIW is that Singapore grows most of the vegetables on the terrace. Right? So if you have terrace with you, what are you doing about it? Right? If you have a balcony, what are you doing with that? Is a question I like to leave you with. Okay? But now we are moving to the last leg, which is a live demonstration. Live demonstration of how to charge your food. One way is through prayer's intention. Other is through what we call as a universal scanner. So amongst us we have Dr. Chandrashekhar, Dr. C.A. Chandrashekhar. May I request you please step forward on the dais here, please. Dr. Chandrashekhar himself is a cancer survivor. He has overcome hepatitis C and he's a master of psychoneurobiotics. And he himself has cured, and he's a gifted person. You got to listen to his story and understand what this is all about. But he's going to demonstrate today how to charge the food. So Dr. Chandrashekhar, it's over to you, and I'm sure you're going to give us a nice demo. Definitely. In a short and precise manner.
Yeah? First of all, I thank Tonisha and very happy birthday to you. If we are all solitaire, then you are the most very best jeweler. Collected all the jewels, put everyone in the right showcase to present to the others. Very good. And today, what I spoke, you're absolutely right. The first is how can you find your instruction manual? Am I right? So today I'm going to show the demonstration how you can find your instruction manual, where it is, okay? And what Sister Shivani told, the best ingredient is the five elements of the mind. What are those? Power, purity, joy, love and peace. Because without these ingredients, nothing is possible. What the Sunil Joshi sir told, Marma therapy, it is very ancient therapy. It is always connected to the heart. That's why he said, aap hamara marm kya samajhte hai, hai na? Marm means emotions. The energy of the mind is emotions. What is emotions? Energy in motion, which instantly evaporates in the air. Like you just put the spray and the whole room is fragrant. It does not take time. So, how to charge water, food, air, anything? We have done the research. I made a research, a person in the Patna, Varshi Sashivani was talking, the overtank water is containing the air of all. From here, just with the divine energy, I charged, and the experiment was tremendous. The person was having the body pain that disappeared just by the water. And today also the demonstration. On last 14th of August at Kulu Manali, I called a scientist. He took the water from different places. We took the water of the Tirtham River, we took the water of the cooler, we took the water of the spring, we took the water of a bislery bottle. I hope many people are there who attended the camp. How many are there? Yes, people are there. Those who have seen live demonstration, they have seen. So why water is not charged? Because water is jailed in the bottle. The vibration of the water when it flows, or the vibration of the water when it falls, that were tested, and you can see what was the entropy. And we tested different waters. The water was waste, the flowing water. Then we charged the water. Many people charged. And when I charged with the divine energy, then the water vibration became more better than the river. It was proved. I'll send this all scientific research to the TQIW, which will be available on the website. As everybody was talking, jaisa an vaisa man, jaisi pani vaisi vani, as jaisi hawa vaisi dawa. ठीक है, जैसी हवा वैसी दवा. ठीक है, बिकॉज इट स्प्रेड फास्टेस्ट, नॉट इवन 20 सेकेंड्स, इट फास्टेस्ट. अंडरस्टैंड? सो आई विल डू द एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन दैट. एंड इफ टीकेआरएलयू इज टेकिंग दिस, वी आर रेडी टू डू द रिसर्च विद द कलेक्टिव पीपल हु कैन कंट्रोल द क्राइम रेट, कंट्रोल द पॉल्यूशन, कंट्रोल द माइंड ऑफ द पीपल. इफ यू आर रेडी, आई एम रेडी टू डू द रिसर्च विद यू. Sir, okay, now I am going to show the demonstration. First, the instruction manual. Any three people can come, any three people, just come.
Just come.
Any three people can come. I want to show where is their instruction manual. See, this is just machine to prove it. This is just the machine to prove it. Okay, where is your instruction manual? Please come here. Keep calm, calm. Come. Abhi aaiye. No problem, no problem. Please come, please come. No problem. Okay, mobile nahi hai na? Mobile pocket mein nahi hota. Haan, mobile aap nikal ke rakh dijiye. Theek hai? Okay. Your instruction manual is your heart. Why heart? Because heart never tells lie. Kisi se aap poochte hain, dil se bol rahe ho? दिल से पूछ के खाते हो कि जीभ से पूछ के खाते हो? किस से पूछ के खाते हैं आज के डेट में? जीभ से. दिल से कोई नहीं पूछता. तो योर इंस्ट्रक्शन मैनुअल इज हियर एंड इट सेज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट योर बॉडी इज रिक्वायर्ड. व्हाट प्रताप सर व्हाट सेलिंग, एवरी बॉडी इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड ऑल द फूड्स. इट्स ऑल डिपेंड ऑन द पर्सन एंड द गॉड हैज गिवन यू द इंस्ट्रक्शन मैनुअल हियर. Okay, what is good, what is bad for you? Okay, so I'll just show you one demonstration of instruction manual. How your instruction manual works only with the emotion. and emotional ingredients of the food. The food is prepared there. It is kept there. Okay?
Food ko lete
hain. Just be in the center and there is a cordless mic. Cordless mic, yeah.
Okay. Abhi.
Dr. Chandrashekhar, you can use this mic.
Okay, thank you. Any two of them?
One. Lady can hold and one.
Okay.
And come in the center here too, you don't mind.
Okay. Okay, fine. Okay. So, if this food is having the right emotion for you, what will happen? Your heart will say, go ahead. If this food is not having right emotions, then your heart will say, no. Okay. So, how you are going to ask the heart? Put it here in the one hand and do the right hand like this. Okay. Come inside. Okay, so what I am going to do, test. This is a universal scanner, the tester of energy. Like the tester is there, you just insert in the socket and find whether energy is there or not. Same way, this is the universal scanner. Body have, any objects have two kind of energy. One is the energy of the food, that is the chemical energy. One is the energy of the emotion, that is bioelectrical energy. We are both. Body is biochemical energy and mind is emotional energy. Okay? Nothing in this world is without emotion. Remember it. Okay? So, ye food aapke liye dawa hai ki nahi? Check karte hain. Aapke heart kya puch raha hai? Just I'll put the finger here, I'll press it. Okay? Ready? Okay. Hold it. She is unable to. Okay. Ready? Okay, so can you see, your heart is telling the emotion is not right. Now you can do one more thing, do like this, look straight and move it, look straight and move, keep it back, no, just look ahead, just rotate your hand and keep it back, okay, can you see, keep it back, so your hand is going up to here. With this foot, his hand is up to here. With this foot, her hand is up to here. Okay? Okay, fine. Now, you just keep the foot there. Okay, how to change the emotion? Okay, one more experiment we'll do. Please come. Okay, now we just do like this. Why I'm doing? Now, I'll check the energy of the air. We are here, we have the emotions. So what are the emotional ingredients of the air? I want to go check it. So how it will be checked? Inhale deeply, inhale, take, inhale deeply, exhale slowly 5 times. So this present air filled with the different emotion is going inside the lungs in the form of air, hawa, okay? Or aapka lungs, heart ke paas kaun hai, dietitian hai, that will tell the changes, if any changes are there in the emotions. Okay, fine. Okay, okay. Inhale 5 times. Okay, fine. Okay, now both of you can do like this, look and do it. Okay, so at the present emotion of air, his hand is almost 180 degree, okay, fine. Her hand is almost 170 degree, okay, fine. Just do like this. Okay. I've just said testing the energy. Hold it. Resist, very good energy. Resist, very good energy. Okay, now down. Now, if someone irritates you sometimes, if someone irritates you sometimes? Yes? Somebody, something irritate you? Okay, just close your eyes. And just recall that image of that. Image of the object or image of the person. Is it there in your mind? Okay, fine. Now do this. Do the same thing.
Okay? Now, resist. Resist, resist, resist. See? Resist. You do like this? Resist. Resist. So what do you see? The moment you recall anything, even objects, even anybody, which makes you irritated, it means your emotion is good or bad? Bad. And that instantly affects body in a fraction of seconds. Understood? In a fraction of seconds. So now what I am going to do, I will not do. Khushi, can you come? Khushi is here, she is a child. Why I am asking her to do? Because if she can do, anyone can do it. She will recharge the air around 1 kilometer from the India International Center. 1 kilometer. And you will see the changes, even with the air, that food will be charged, their energy will be charged instantly. And whole food kept outside, that will be charged. Hold the water kept outside, it will be charged. Plant will be charged instantly. Okay, just do it. You can sense the emotional fragrance. Inhale deeply 5 times, all of you. Inhale, inhale deeply 5 times. Everybody, all your emotions are cleansed. So how it is cleansed? इसलिए आपने अन्न सुना मन सुना पानी सुना वाणी सुना लेकिन अभी क्या सुना आपने जैसा हवा वैसा दवा और if we charge the हवा of the hospital, hawa of any place, the few, only 5% required, that's all. And 5% can create the miracles for the people are suffering. Everybody can't do that. But we have to help. Understand? So now we'll check the increase in energy. All of you, just come here, stand and do the same thing. Same thing, and move it fully back. Move it fully back, move it fully back. Move it fully back, move it fully back. Can you see? Can you see the energy is increased? I'm not pulling their hand. Okay. Now you can take that food. Put at the same place. You also have the same food. Just do it. Okay, I'm going to put the pressure. Can you see? And see, do you feel the energy increased? Do you feel the energy? See, I am putting much pressure, much pressure, much pressure. Energy is increased. So this is the proof. Now I'll prove it with this also. You see? Can you see it's not moving? So this is the proof that the air is charged, people are charged, this food is charged, water is charged. Okay? And if you want to learn how to recharge the water, I have written in July magazine of the Life Positive. On the page number 70, you can find how you can transmit the energy into the water, to vibrate the water, to make the vibration to the level of the flowing river, because today water is dead with the sealed water. So this magazine is available there, you can all of you can take it, this is free. While going, you carry this, see the 70 page and you can learn how to do it. Okay, so I will not take much of time, everything is charged, Tony sir is charged, thank you, everything is charged. God bless all of you.
Tony, let's thank all those people who made this event possible and made this event so successful. Let me begin by first saying a big thanks to all of you for being here in large numbers. And as Tony keeps saying that these are the gems of PQIW community, and it's good to see so many happy faces here. You can be louder for yourself, I think we all deserve it. And thank you, Tony and Rajat, for putting this great event together, because this is a often discussed topic, but we do not dwell too much into detail of what we eat and what we consume, but it's very important. And me being a personal beneficiary of this, in the last 1 year, I have knocked off 12 kgs. But today's session has demolished some of my own myths. Yeah, though I thought I was doing pretty well, but there are so many things which got validated, and there were some myths which have got demolished. So I would like to thank all the speakers, all the presenters. You did a great job. I think time was a great constraint, but despite that, you were able to come across to all of us and convey what you want to do. Volunteers led by Sadhana, all Sadhana's angels, wherever you are, big hand to all of them, because to put an event of this magnitude, it takes a huge effort, and all of them have done a great job. Then Indian International Center, I think they are always very, very gracious to host us, and every time we go back with great experience. So thank you so much, guys. Vaibhav for clicking us while we were consuming all what was being given to us. So Vaibhav, good show, very well done. Then we have Lakshya Studios, who has done the videography for us. Jeeva was gracious enough to give us the hampers, and I would now call Tony. Before I do that, Shivani ji, every time I listen to you, it's very enlightening. I think all of us should give a big hand to Shivani for being there with us throughout the evening. It was very, very enlightening. So may I request Tony and Rajat to please come forward, and may invite all the presenters one more time to be with us on the stage, so that we can hand over these hampers to you. Dr. Chauhan, please up. May we get the hampers, please?
Rajat, if you take care of that, and I'll just make one or two quick announcements. Are you finished? Your announcements?
I'm going to class for the MC.
Okay. So I'll do that.
Okay, you'll do.
Meenu, what happened to you? You went to for the food.
I went to check on the
food. Come quickly.
We have to have another photo because Meenu got left out. Come.
Now I have the phone, I'm taking the photograph with you too.
Yeah, absolutely. Have you got it? Can we get closer? You go back. Thank you, ABS. And well, I want to take this opportunity to thank Rajinder Sood, our master of ceremonies. He's outstanding. Without him, we couldn't have put this together. We have two employees of TQRW, Rajna Khanna Singh and Kansha Bhagwana Kaul. You know, they've done a magnificent job. I want to thank all our speakers who made it a point to come on time and go through the presentations with us, and all of you for being here with us and sticking it out to this late in the evening. There's a sequence to this that we had to complete, and in order to complete it, it is just not possible to do it anything less than the time that we had to spend on this very important subject. It takes a lot of effort to put this together, and you can't leave it halfway in between. Yeah, and we operate to certain hours of operations of the IIC and so on and so forth. So I know this is a very late dinner, but please enjoy it and sleep a little later tonight, but allow enough time for digestion. And we hope you'll go to our website and have a look at the website. We've got a button there called Give Us Feedback. We're a total quality organization. Belief system kind of place. We love feedback. We treat feedback as a gift, not as a criticism. So please give us our feedback on that. Any suggestions that you may have or feedback for the event, that will help us to continuously improve in what we are doing. Thank you very much. Thank you for everybody who's been here with us today. We really appreciate all the endeavor that you have made, and God bless. Thank you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.